Hello, YouTube. We're back. We're back. Puy de Dôme today. A chance to see what damage has been done over the last 10 days of being away from home, away from my bike, and only on a gym bike. I'm gonna sneeze. Just finishing my warm-up. I'm doing this for a few reasons. Number one is obviously because I'm 10 days away, I want to find out where I'm at again. So it's a bit of an experiment, but also plenty of people out there who maybe work away, go away on business trips, or maybe they go away on holiday with family and they're desperate to sort of maintain fitness. This is also a bit of a bro science experiment where for those 10 days I was away, I was doing the odd ride on a gym bike with some short intervals. So we'll see if that actually made any kind of difference. We've obviously got not much to compare it to, apart from 15 years of me getting ill, coming back. So we do have something to compare it to in a way, but not, it's not an out-to-out direct comparison. For the sake of the people watching, for the sake of simplicity and a continuity, because before I went away I did a 20 minute effort and I did a full Alpe de Zwift effort. For the sake of continuing that, I'm gonna do a 20 to 30 minute max effort up the Puy de Dôme using those numbers from 10 days ago as a benchmark. If I can get close to those numbers and then die off at the end, that's probably the best way for me to pace this, because if I undercook it, we won't really learn anything from it. If I overcook it, then I know at least I gave it a good go. So I was off for 10 days. I was away in a different country with my dad, looking after him for 10 days. So away from my bike, doing a good deed, as some would say. But here we are. I will make a proper YouTube video of this, because I think it can be useful for a lot of people, even if the result isn't what we want. But open mind, we go into this with an open mind and see what we can do. On the Puy de Dôme, thank you, Andrew. Yes, he is on the mend, yeah, but he certainly wouldn't have been able to do it without me there. So I earned my sun point, brownie point, for sun of the year already, and it's only February. I did enjoy Lithuania, let's be honest, I did enjoy it. I did get out and about, I met some new people, mainly that worked in cafes, because that's where I was going a lot of the time, but did a bit of exploring on 2 feet. I did kind of. I mean, I rode all the way up to it and then, you know, did those couple of tests and Alpe de Zwift just before going out. So in theory it was, you know, it was a good way to lead into it and then stop. Obviously I didn't completely have 10 days completely off the bike, but that's where we're going with the title of said video. You know, I took 10 days of no cycling and lost blank watts. Or maybe I gained watts. but obviously, take it with a pinch of salt. It is only a singular effort. We're not testing, you know, different lengths, critical power. We're not testing for all ranges. This is only a very specific one-off effort, so keep that in mind. Yeah. Thank you, Martin. I did make friends with that gym bike. Yeah, Cheddar Gorge. I mean, Cheddar Gorge is crap, isn't it? I mean, just kidding. We are at Ed Mode 0.5 currently, yes. And maybe Ed Mode 0.2 by the time we get to the top of Puy de Dôme. Cool, look at that view there. I don't recall the view being that good. That's really nice, actually. Good morning, Josh. Andrew, no, I will not be watching NFL, mainly because I'm still trying to catch up on sleep. We didn't get back into the UK until, like, just after midnight, 2 days ago, so... Well, a day ago, actually. So, I'm still catching up on some sleep. So I'm not going to stay up any longer. Early night. It's important now, actually. I've really got to get back into a routine. Like the last 2 or 3 months has been the worst, I think, start to a season for me in a long time in terms of, you know, maybe I was getting ill and then I was getting back into it. Then I went away and then so... You know, there's lots of things that really disrupted my routine and consistency, and that's one of the things that sometimes if you just don't even follow structured training and you're just riding your bike most days, and you know, you'll get fitter that way regardless, or at least maintain. So I need to restart all over again, to a certain extent. So yeah, got to build up for the Zwift games, got Battle on the Beach again. Going away to Tenerife in a couple of weeks, you know, and I'm not going to be fit for Tenerife, you know, I say I'm going to be fit, but I'm going to have no form maybe, so, you know, the ideas that I had, you know, the fun things to do in Tenerife, I maybe can't really do because I'm just going to be really tired from riding my bike, but we'll see what we could do. I mean, yeah, maybe just use it as a training camp. Sadly. Yes, that is very true. Yeah, usually with time off, you're more towards the anaerobic, you're freshen up. Yeah, you don't have a chance to look at that video, that is true. Wow, if I was to have a year off the bike, where would you start? Well, you would probably need a few months of just riding your bike to begin with, before you even think about structured training plans. Yeah, because a year is a long, long time. I mean, there's people who stop cycling in their 20s and then come back into it in their 40s or 50s, and that's obviously even longer than a year. A lot of them start back or discover their love for cycling again by riding on Zwift. And the irony is, that's all they do is Zwift race, so that's all they do is do the Zwift training plans. But years ago, like, you would still have to generally work yourself back into doing something like that. Like, that's where the traditional approach is still somewhat true, rings true. Because you, like, you know, you're not really building on top of anything. As soon as you jump onto a platform like this with the temptation of intensity being the first thing you do straight away, Like, yes, you see improvements, don't get me wrong. You know, I mean, I'd be stupid if I said you wouldn't see any improvements, but you'd get to a point where you'd have to do something else. Yeah, we're heading to Puy de Dôme now. Patience, patience. We're getting there. The difference is, if you use Scotland as an example, the difference is consistency comes in different forms. So, you know, I might sit here and say, oh, you need to do like lots of low and slow, you know, aerobic base, quote unquote, before you get there if you've had a long time off. But if you've ridden for 10 years in a very unstructured manner, that's still, you know, you've still done an equivalent of a base because you've been consistent over a long period of time. So there's no like one answer. It's definitely on a case by case basis. No, this was the climb that Poggy dropped the onus on. It's the one that Mike Woods won on. It's like absolutely savagely steep at the top. That's this one. Okay, so like I said, I'm gonna ride at about 350 watts, I think. And I just try and hold on to it because that's roughly what I had the last time we did something like this, which was obviously before I left 10 days ago. So we're gonna just sit at that and see what comes of it, basically. So here we go. We'll have a look at Strava after this as well, because it's not going to break down the effort for us. We'll have to do that ourselves. Okay. There she is. 100%. Almost 34 minutes on the clock exactly, so. we've got to pass there that I fall. Training difficulty, low, cab. No, disagree, John. I need a hand here. Come on, Jesus. Thank you. Does it go blue at all? I need to know. Come on. Not bad. Well, there's no excuse for you not to do that if I've just done that. Oh my word. I was so on the limit from like 5k to go. Basically, as soon as we hit the last steep bit, the corkscrew and everything, that last 5k, I thought like... And then someone in the chat said we were halfway, and I was like, well, we're not halfway distance, but halfway in time. And that kind of semi-crushed me because I was on the limit at that point, and because it... Yeah, I wasn't in the right frame of mind to take that that information. But wow, okay, so I did better than I did think that I would do, and wow. There was no way I wasn't going to finish that. It was just, I had to check myself before I crushed myself. I was just really ambitious at the start to try and hold the power that I averaged like 10 days, 2 weeks ago. But I had to do that. Like, you know, if I hadn't gone out above what I thought I would manage, then I would probably like underpace it. And that's not something that you hear me say often, but in this situation, you know, when we're trying to do like a little bit of a comparison with 10 days off, then I need to basically throw it all on the line in order to see. Now that we know there's an accurate number there, then obviously I can pace it differently, but... Oh... Oh, that cleared the tubes. Oh, chest. And that length of time as well, it's just really important. Like, you know, you get to that 20-minute point and you're already, you're breathing really hard, and then, you know, you've still got a little bit of heart rate drift in you, and definitely VO2 max at the end, blimey. So I guess the results for that effort, we averaged, what was it, 346? Maybe I can go back a little bit in the stream and see. 346 watts. So what I did a couple of weeks ago, or 10 days ago, was, I'll just check it actually. But, it's virtually the same. It's virtually the same. So, what's my max heart rate? Max heart rate is probably around about 185, but hang on, let me just check it. So, 357. When did I do that? Oh yeah, when did I do that? There it was. So I did 344 watts for 37 minutes. A couple of weeks ago. So I essentially did the same power. I can't be right, surely. I mean, I'm still going to make a video on this because I need to break down what I did over those 10 days. But looking at that effort I did, yes, there's a couple of minutes difference, but effectively it's exactly the same. Average heart rate, I think my average heart rate would have been like, just trying to do averages there on the side of the screen, maybe 170, 100, between 165 and 170 average heart rate for that effort there today. And yeah, maybe slightly higher actually than a couple of weeks ago. So maybe that's the only difference. The only difference is my heart is slightly higher, but you'd expect that anyway. Pacing, different, obviously different. So I went off a little bit harder in this one. But in the effort 10 days ago, it was a little bit more steady throughout. I had to have a couple of like micro rests during this one, but 163 average, 176 max heart rate last time, whereas this time, yeah, it's probably max of 180. So a little bit different, but not, but in fact, you know, numbers wise, number for number, it's yeah, there's no difference at all. But everybody's different, of course. But that's a very interesting, finding. Actually, one that has made me feel a lot better about maybe future trips and things. I don't know. So, yeah, my dad's all right. Thanks, Josh. Yeah, went for an op. Long story short, basically couldn't afford the operation in the UK, so went for the operation abroad, and yeah. Didn't fancy waiting on the NHS basically, so I've been waiting long enough anyway, so Yeah, definitely a bit more fatigued last time. I know I did a 20-minute test a couple of days before it, but yeah, that's pretty decent actually. I wonder what my 20 minutes was for this effort. I don't really fancy doing this descent, but so 20 minutes would have been about 3:47, so it's about 10 watts less. But obviously, I was pacing for a full effort, so. Well, I mean, yeah. You can just see there, like how I'm slowly starting to fade. Took me three little recovery sections there. My heart is still gradually rising, but then that was it then. Just tried to go all in and had something at the end there to go really deep, but that kind of comes with that freshness in my experience. So, yeah. All right, cool. Thanks for... Thanks for joining me on that. You definitely helped me, definitely motivated me there to dig in for that last bit, because I was starting to fall apart a little bit, but yeah. Thanks a lot. That's well worth my time. So hopefully it inspired you to go and do what you're gonna do today on the bike. So thank you so much. I will catch you in a video. Or a Zwift race on Tuesday night, maybe. I'll see you then.